Okay, thank you very much. Thank you for coming today. I'm George Ioannidis. I'm a reproductive gynecologist working at MHTERA Hospital. MHTERA Hospital is one of the largest maternity hospitals in Greece, delivering around 6,000 to 7,000 babies annually. And we have one of the largest IVF units in the Balkans with approximately 1,500. The medical tourism was not always in Greece. It's not always in Greece. It's not only for IVF. It's been around for many years. And actually, it's been invented by the ancient Greeks, where there was a comprehensive network of medical tourism, especially at the Asclepios temple, which was the world's first health centers. The same thing was happening in Epidaurus, at the sanctuary of Zeus in Olympia, and the temple of Delphi. So it's not something new. Why do you need to come? Why do you have to come to Greece to do IVF in 2020? There are three major components on that. There are three major routes why to do that. The first thing is the success rates. The second thing is the legal aspect that resides in Greece. And the third thing is the ethics that is among the whole thing. So let's speak about success. In Greece and at MHTERA IVF unit, we provide all the IVF techniques that are available in the market, from IVF to ICSI, from egg donation to surrogacy of pregnancy, and from pregenetic screening to sex selection if there are some specific gene disorders that we have this problem. The second thing is the law. Greece is very famous because of the liberal legal aspect which is behind all the IVF treatments. The law is updated, the law is liberal, the law is detailed, and the most important, the law provides full protection for your couples that they come to Athens, they come to Greece to do IVF in order to do all the necessary techniques, either it's egg donation, surrogacy, pregenetic screening, sperm or embryo freezing, and gamete transfer. All the units, and especially our unit, the IVF MHTERA unit, is being regulated by the Greek National Authority of Assisted Reproduction. Our unit is fully licensed, so it complies all the European regulations in order to apply all these techniques. And we provide IVF to couples up to the age of 50. This is a big difference compared to other countries, especially in Europe, that the limit is either at 42 or 45 years old. The second thing is that we allow surrogacy of the pregnancy, and the surrogate mother needs to up to the age of 45. We apply egg donation, and the donors are from the age of 20 up to the age of 35. We do a huge quality control, and we do all the legal paperwork in order to prepare the couples and to come straight to do the IVF technique. Let's talk about the egg donation. The egg donation is amongst the biggest problems in the Western countries in the world, either in Europe or either continental Europe or in the States. And Greece is very famous for providing egg donation techniques because the whole process is fully regulated. The cost is low compared either to the continental Europe or to the American market. There is a large donor pool. There's no waiting list. All the donors follow a comprehensive blood examination, and the success rates are very, very high. The egg donation relies on altruism, and there is a specific, amount that's been specified by the Greek authorities in order to compensate the donors for what they do. They follow all the donors, they follow a detailed medical history, we check their DNA, we check whether they suffer either from thalassemia or cystic fibrosis, which are gene disorders that they are related with medical problems, or the fragile X, which is related to infertility. We have a very strict policy and very strict regulation about who the donor is. And this is because Greece complies with all the European regulation to avoid trafficking, which is a very important thing in all around Europe. So all the donors have to have compulsory a permanent address in Greece, and they've been tested for gene tests for the foreign donors. The success rates, you see, in all around Europe that and in all around the world that the egg donation is allowed, that the success rate in Greece, it's above 60%. And as we'll explain to you a little bit later, the success rate in our unit goes much, much higher, even up to 80%. The next thing, pregenetic screening. Pregenetic screening is to test the embryos for medical disorders or for medical problems or for inherited problems before we implant the embryos into the woman's uterus. The pregenetic screening can be applied in couples as well that they have recurrent implantation failure, they have several failures in the IVF. We can apply that if women have recurrent miscarriages, if they have the couple, either the father or the mother, have a chromosomal abnormality, and the pregenetic screening will give us all this important information because before we get this woman pregnant. Sex selection, very important. Sex selection for family balance is not allowed in Greece. We cannot do that. And we think this is right. On the other hand, if there is a sex-linked problem, a sex-linked chromosomal problem, that means, in simple words, if we have a family problem that if you have a boy, this will suffer and this can die because of this problem. If you have a female, if you have a girl, it's going to survive. Then the law allows that to do that. Surrogacy. One major thing that we provide here in Greece. Surrogacy is the technique when a woman cannot carry out a pregnancy because most commonly of a medical condition that she has. And when a woman, if she's going to die or her health is going to be in great risk. So in that case, we get eggs from this woman, we fertilize them with the sperm of her husband, and we transfer the embryos into a surrogate mother in order to give birth to this child. Surrogacy, it's a big question because it questions all the fundamental certainties in the human beings about who is the mother. And who is the mother, it can be divided in three roles: the genetic, the gestational means the ones that gives birth, and the social, the one that grows up the child. There's a huge industry in all around the world, especially in India, in the States, about the surrogacy. In a lot of the countries all around the world, there are no strict regulation. The difference here in Greece is that the cost, obviously, it's much, much cheaper compared to other countries. The second thing, it's very strictly regulated. And in order to do surrogacy in Greece, you need to get a license from the court. This happens in Greece, you can see in yellow. There are a lot of countries in all around Europe with red that surrogacy is not allowed. So this is a big area of expertise that we can provide full services. So the surrogate mother, you need to know, is not entitled to decide what is happening with the fetus. This has to do with the genetic parents of the embryos. But the surrogate mother renounces to her rights at an early stage with regard to the medical examinations that she's going to follow and regarding the autonomy in decisions at the beginning of the pregnancy. The law says that there's no compensation for that. It's regulated as a preterm, pre-birth adoption, and we need to get a license from the court. And as a unit, we can organize everything for the couple. So, why to do IVF in Greece, in summary? Because of the Greek hospitality. Because all of our doctors, they are English spoken and trained. Most of the IVF doctors in Greece, they are British trained. All of us as well at MHTERA IVF unit, we are British trained. We are EU member. The legislation is liberal. The license is very strict. And all the IVF units, including the MHTERA IVF unit, is strictly regulated by the National Independent Authority. So this is us. This is MHTERA Hospital. This is MHTERA IVF unit within the hospital. And this is us, all of us. And Dr. Christopoulos now will explain to you very briefly why, apart from coming to Greece to do IVF, you need to come to MHTERA IVF in order to fulfill your wishes. Thanks for your attention.